Hello, and welcome to Geek Out with Perry. We launched the Microsoft Trust Center, which contains information on our privacy practices in Office 365 and Exchange Online. But we still get a lot of questions from customers around how we manage the privacy and security of their data in Exchange Online. So what I wanted to focus on today is how we manage access in Exchange Online. I know we've discussed RBAC in the past, but what else do we do to manage access?
Right. Well, we've talked in the past a bit about how we've tried to engage the entire engineering team in running the service. Mm-hmm. That means there's a lot of people potentially with access to the data center. So we have to spend a lot of time thinking about making sure that that's well controlled. The first thing, sort of the basis of all of this is that everybody has to go through a fairly thorough background check to make sure that everybody is who we think they are, working for us and not foreign companies or foreign governments, or not working for themselves. So we think we've got a really good story there. And of course, as you mentioned, that we have our RBAC system that allows us to create roles and tightly control who's got access to what based on what they need to do. Mm-hmm. But we don't think that that's sufficient.
Okay, so what else do we do in order to manage access?
Right. So the key principle that we've been operating on is the idea of zero elevated access.
Okay.
So that nobody during normal operations has access to anything. We think that's important because there's an awful lot of things that even you sort of think of as regular non-destructive operations, like just rebooting a single service or installing a new server, can have big implications in the system if you're doing it with in bulk, right? If you restart all the servers in the system, you're actually going to create a service outage. Or if you install on top of a perfectly functioning server, you can do a lot of damage. So even just to prevent mistakes, not even worrying about malicious activity, you want to make sure that nobody is going to be doing things when they're not realizing it. So people do not have access under normal circumstances. So let's take a scenario. Somebody wakes up in the middle of the night, they get a call, they do a little bit of an investigation, and they discover that they need to restart a service. They're a little grumpy, and they've got something that's going to take them 10 seconds to fix get the system back online. Mm-hmm. There's going to be a bug that's going to follow up to fix the underlying issue, but to restore service, they need to restart something. So how are they going to do that? Because they can't do that out of the box. All right. And the thing that allows them to do that is something called Lockbox. The grumpy engineer makes a request, explicit request, to elevate his privileges for the operation that he needs to do.
Okay.
Lockbox then checks whether or not his scope of his role allows him to actually get that elevated privilege.
Okay.
And if it can decide that, yes, it does have it, in which case it'll grant the permission, let's say starting a service, for a limited period of time, and make him a nice, happy engineer who gets to go back to bed in 30 seconds after he's got the service up and running and confirmed that it's all functioning.
Okay.
Or it could decide that, the operation there is within his scope, but does require somebody else to, another human being, to get involved.
Okay.
The principle here is the same principle as, you know, two people being required to launch nuclear missiles, right?
Mm-hmm.
You have to have two people to confirm certain kinds of operations. These things can be, again, like doing install work or stuff like that, require an extra level of operations. Usually it involves things that are going to write data or delete data, are the things that are potentially permanently destructive. Okay, so that sends off a mail to another engineer who doesn't have access to the request, checks it, gives permission, and then permission is granted through an automatic system. And all of these requests then get audited, and we've got a choke point that we can review and monitor every single incident of elevated privileges that go through in the system over the course of the previous week or the previous day, and review those with regular meetings.
Mm-hmm.
So overall, we think this system provides the absolute minimum amount of elevated privileges at any given time.
Okay.
Only those operations absolutely necessary are permitted during the period in which they are needed.
Okay.
But as soon as the privileges are not needed, they're automatically revoked, and we're back to a situation in which he's working on a test system and is doing a bunch of operations. He can't make the mistake of doing those operations against the live service. They will simply fail.
Okay. Thanks, Perry. And thanks for watching and learning about our Lockbox technology in Exchange Online. Please continue to watch all of the Geek Out with Perry videos and check out Perry's blog.